There's no business like show business, like no business that we know. But that would be none of our business. Welcome to The Hump! Well, let me introduce our darling panel today, as we have a few new guests with us. We've got Jason.
Hi, Soph.
And we've got Pat, who's from The Music Box.
Hi, Soph.
And Julius, welcome back.
Shalom.
Good to have you. Well, before we begin, let's check out today's news.
Today, we pay tribute to performer John English, who died last week. You won't find many tributes like this on CX Network, because you won't find someone as loved by technical crew as old Black Ice. John English didn't try to be a nice guy, he just was one. He respected his crew and they loved him for it. I worked on shows with him in the 70s and 80s and he always said hello. I saw the influence he had on other performers who behaved better afterwards. In show business, crew often only hear about it when something goes wrong. John made sure we heard about it when things were right. Meanwhile, over in New Zealand, the industry are adjusting to a new Health and Safety Work Act, which starts in April. NZ has many more work accidents and deaths per population than Australia. We hope the tighter laws don't affect extreme sports like zorbing and bungee jumping, because we love extreme sport here at CX.
Jason, I know you've got some new gear. Tell us about it.
As always, Sophie. Now, it's always nice to talk about Australian product on the show. So this week, we're going to be talking about the Acoustic Technologies SCX28 monitor speaker. So this is a new dual-angle monitor wedge from the company. But you can also whack it on a pole and stick it up in front of house if you feel like it. It's made of premium birch ply, and it's finished with AT's proprietary Acousticoat finish. Very shiny. It's got a 15-inch and in the low with handling 800 watts and high frequency of 160 watts, and it can be bi-amped, and its horn dispersion is 60 by 40. Now, Pat, you got any AT stuff in stock at the
moment? No, nothing in stock.
It usually ends up in a lot of installs, I find.
Yeah,
seen on a lot of walls and places around. And yeah, you dealt with them much over the years?
Oh, I know Harry Lloyd Williams. Yeah. It's one of the few Australian manufacturers.
Yeah, and that's why it's good to be able to talk about Australian-developed product on the show. So, yeah, we always like getting behind the Aussie stuff. So, yeah. Okay, well, on my radar this week again, and on pretty much everybody's, is Donald Trump. First he had a go at the sound tech, now he's having a go at the lighting. Let's have a look at the video.
We put them in our jails, because to put them in our jails, they didn't pay the electric bill. To put them, oh, I like that much better. Oh. Oh, that's so much better. Those lights were brutal. Are they come from the dishonest press? Where? Oh, don't turn them off. Forget it. Better, right? Don't turn them on. Don't turn the lights on. Plus, we save on electricity, right? No, get those lights off. Off. Turn them off. They're too bright. Turn them off. Turn them off. Let's go. Ready? Turn off the lights. Turn off the lights! Turn off the lights! Turn them off! So much nicer. Two great guys, they work hard, they love, boom, they love, get those lights off! They're taunting us. They're taunting us, all right. I love you too. Look at that guy. I love you. Beautiful.
I can't believe it.
It's hard to watch, isn't it?
I can believe it. It's Donald Trump.
It is.
It's almost heading to violence.
Yeah, there's a certain crowd mob mentality in the chanting and the sort of, you know, just leading along with whatever he says, I find quite chilling. Mm.
You hear his numbers are going down, but sometimes I feel like maybe, is this getting more followers?
I definitely think it's getting more followers. It's not a place we need to be going, though.
No. Have you ever had to work on a gig like that?
Nothing that full on. I've done a lot of media events, but nothing that sort of outrageous.
Yeah. It does make me wonder, like, as technicians, at what point do we actually just turn it off and walk away?
I know.
I'm not having any of this.
Because that guy or girl was on a hiding for nothing. It didn't matter what they did. He picked up on a theme, which is basically to be contrary.
Yeah.
And to incite the crowd.
It just seems that no matter what kind of cheap theatrics he goes for, it just sort of works somehow.
If I was on lighting, I would have kept the lights up. I wouldn't have listened to him.
Done like a chase or something.
The operator fell into that by fading the lights out at the point as a kind of a cue to illustrate his point. And he jumped on it then.
Yeah.
Oh, it's chilling stuff. Today on CX Academy, we're going to look at tying one of the simplest but most useful knots for rigging, the split infinitive. Like most knots, there's a simple mnemonic that will help you remember how to tie it. So let's start. The captain comes out of the cockpit, bothers the waitress, builds an investment portfolio, directs an off-Broadway production, teases the mongoose, is indecisive about breakfast, runs a half marathon, and fills out the logbook. It's simple, effective, and easy. If you need a stronger infinitive to hold heavier loads, you can tease an extra mongoose or be indecisive about, say, superannuation instead. Some riggers skip directing the off-Broadway production, but this results in a knot that's more like a slow Rodney than a split infinitive and isn't suitable for most dead-hung, well-hung, or drawn-out metaphors. Until next time, the more you know, the less that you know that you don't know.
Welcome back. So I'm talking now about site inductions. Pat, you've probably done a number of those.
Done a lot of them, yeah.
Have them on a daily basis. Mm-hmm. If you go to a different venue every day, we've been to 15 different venues on our roadshows, and most of them make you do an online internet-style thing that runs 15 to 20 minutes.
Mm-hmm. Often longer.
Often longer, with a bit of a test. And what always amazes me is that utter and complete lack of follow-on when you actually get to the venue.
Absolutely.
Where you're lucky if there's one person turns up to welcome you, and they never ever do a verbal induction. They never do a, by the way, do you know where the emergency gathering area is? They don't do it.
Yeah. It's just not high on their priority list.
No. I've printed out a small forest of certificates, you know, saying, you know, here I am, I've done this. I don't think I've actually ever showed one to another human being.
Have you?
Never.
Wow, that's impressive. Never. So we're actually...
I've got an induction. One of the best inductions was at a venue where they just make one person from the company do the induction, and then if they're inducted, it's assumed that they will tell everyone else who's working for them where to go.
Yeah.
It's reasonably sensible.
To be honest, it's actually more practical and it makes sense because I will then take the responsibility on that I have to tell people where the bathrooms are, where the emergency evacuation area, assembly area is. Mm. Yeah, then rather than the online log in and everyone have to do it. And then also there's a question is how do you bill that?
We need a national card. We need a single card for this industry, for live performance.
Yeah, absolutely.
A white card, red card, I don't care what colour the card is. But we need a card.
We do.
Where every year we all do a refresher. Mm-hmm. And we've got our card and it's got our photo on it.
Yep. Mm-hmm. I like it.
How hard is that?
Yeah. Mm. And I mean, the stuff like, do I really need to know how to do the right paperwork to dispose of asbestos on site? Because I'm pretty sure if you're asking me to move asbestos, you've asked the wrong person.
Yeah, absolutely.
We decided to be diligent, went to a new venue this year on CX Roadshow, turned up at 4:45 in the morning at the security office, went knock, knock, knock. This poor little bloke's asleep behind the... He opens the door up, he looks out, there's 14 loaders and there's three of us. There's 17 blokes standing there, each of us a bit of paper. He didn't know what to do.
So when you actually do show them to someone, it just confuses them.
Totally confused.
Absolutely.
All right. Well, it's a sad state of affairs, but let's have a look at what's in Gearbox this week. This is the AT-ND971 from Audio-Technica, a boundary microphone. Boundary microphones, not terribly thrillingly interesting in and of themselves.
Unless you've got like a conferencing application.
Yeah. This one, Cat 5. That's it. There is no analog output on this microphone. So how can this be? Okay, so this is one of the first microphones on the market that just outputs Dante, and that's all it outputs, but also outputs a bit of control through the capacitance switch on the front.
That's cute.
So there's a couple of different ways to actually set up and operate this. Now, the first of which, the simple one, there's a bunch of small switches you can press on the back where you can set gain to either plus 30, plus 40, or plus 50 dB. Or you can put the switch on the front into two modes, so either on and off. So that's what we are at the moment by default. Red is off, green is on.
Or momentary.
Yep, or push to talk, basically. There's also an 80 Hertz low cut, which you can engage. Now, what gets interesting is that you can hook this up. Now, at the moment, as of the recording of this video, Biamp's Tessera software, Bose's Control Space, and Symmetric's SimNet Composer can all control this microphone remotely,
where they can
fiddle with a lot more of it. And then what you can do is you can actually set that button to do pretty much anything you want in your control space.
Well, we hope you enjoyed the show today. That's all we've got for the hump, but we'll be back next week with more. See you then.
Gotcha. See ya.